Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters in Islam. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'dih. Wa na'udhu billahi ta'ala min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lah. Wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Verily, all praises due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guide, none can lead astray. And whomsoever went astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. May Allah peace and blessing be upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah that Allah Azza wa Jal enabled us to live for another Ramadan and to witness a great month in the year, the greatest month in the year, the month of Ramadan. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the month where Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the Quran. هدى للناس, as guide for the people, وبينات من الهدى والفرقان, and as will clear evidences from the guidance from the recited verses of the Quran. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This is a great, the greatest month in the year, and this is the greatest opportunity that Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us with. That Allah Azza wa Jal guided us to Islam, and Allah Azza wa Jal enabled us to live for a great month, the month of Ramadan. My brothers and sisters in Islam, in the month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will beautify his Jannah. My brothers in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal in the month of Ramadan will beautify the Jannah, the paradise, and the month of Ramadan, that Allah Azza wa Jal will open the gates of Jannah. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا دَخَلَ رَمَضَانَ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِقَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَهَنَّمِ وَسُلْسِلَةِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. He said, alayhi salatu wa salam, when Ramadan started, until the end of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will open the gates of Jannah. And Allah Azza wa Jal will close the gates of the hellfire. And Allah Azza wa Jal will lock the devils in chain. So in the month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal is informing us that He has opened the gates of His mercy and to encompass all His servants and the people who submit to His will, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And if they fear His punishment, Allah Azza wa Jal has closed the gates of Jahannam in order to inform them that His mercy, tabaraka wa ta'ala, will be encompassing those people who surrender to Him by submitting to Him in Islam. And if you have issues with the devils, if you have issues with your shaitan, then Allah Azza wa Jal has locked the devils in chains. So it's only your nafs. You need to fight your nafs. You need to fight your desire in order to keep it firm upon the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the month of Ramadan, that Allah Azza wa Jal has honored this month, that it became the best month in the year, because Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the Quran in the month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored the night of Al-Qadr, which is in the month of Ramadan, because Allah has revealed the Quran in that night. And that's why it became the best night in the year, subhanallah. And it is better than 1,000 months. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored Jibreel alayhi salam, because he came down with the Quran. And he became the master of the angels, alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salatu wassalam. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that because Allah has revealed the Quran on him, he became the master of the mankind and the jinn kind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah Azza wa Jal will honor anything that is attached to the Quran, including the Muslims who recite the Quran and learn the Quran, where Allah messenger alayhi salatu wassalam, he said, Allah's Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam said, خَيُّرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best one amongst you are the ones who learn the Quran and the ones who teach the Quran. My brothers in Islam, the month of Ramadan In every single day and every single night in the month of Ramadan, Allah will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that in every single day and every single night, that Allah azza wa jalla will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. And for every Muslim, there is a dua that Allah will be accepting this dua. And this is for the one who are fasting, subhanallah. In the month of Ramadan, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih." Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan out of faith in Allah Azza wa Jal and fearing the accountability in the day of judgment, then Allah Azza wa Jal will expiate all his previous sins. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as well, he said in hadith, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih." Whoever did Qiyam al-Layl, the night prayer, during the month of Ramadan, then out of faith in Allah Azza wa Jal and fearing the accountability in the day of judgment, Allah Azza wa Jal will expiate all his previous sins. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal has prescribed to us in the Quran to fast the month of Ramadan in order to gain piety, in order to be closer to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the true fasting in the month of Ramadan is not just only abstaining from the food and the drink and the sexual desire. It's as well abstaining yourself from the sins, meaning that you need to fight your own desire in the month of Ramadan. So this is the important thing in the month of Ramadan. So my brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jal will make the angels to seek forgiveness for the believers, those ones who are fasting the month of Ramadan, subhanallah. And in the days and the nights of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in every single day and every single night in the month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. Subhanallah. This is a great ni'mah. This is a great ni'mah from Allah Azza wa Jal. We should take advantage of the month of Ramadan. If you didn't do much since the beginning of Ramadan, there is a lot yet to come. So you should increase your efforts towards the end of Ramadan. And as well, do your best, inshallah ta'ala, for the coming days of the month of Ramadan in order to gain the mercy and the blessing from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the important thing that to remember that in the month of Ramadan, that Allah Azza wa Jal, he mentioned that the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam related to the month of Ramadan, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith that the fasting and the Quran will intercede for the person in the day of judgment. The fasting will say to Allah, "Oh Allah, I prevented him from the food and the drink and even his sexual desire." And the Quran will intercede on behalf of the person, will say, "Oh Allah, I prevented him from sleeping in the night. He was reciting me throughout the night." So this is what we should do as Muslims, as believers in Allah Azza wa Jal, to do our best towards the end of Ramadan and take advantage of every single day and every single night and be amongst those who Allah Azza wa Jal freed them from the punishment of the hellfire. There are a lot of things, my brothers and sisters, especially that we should be careful while we are fasting. When you are fasting, you shouldn't just only thinking that you abstain yourself from the food and the drink and the sexual desire. It's as well as Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu, he said, when you fast, let your hearing fast with you, let your seeing fast with you, let your tongue fast with you. And in order to be closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and gain the reward and the blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless you all, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to increase us all in knowledge and iman, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to be amongst those who Allah Azza wa Jal freed them from the punishment of the hellfire, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal that to be amongst those who Allah encompass them with His blessing and His mercy in the month of Ramadan. Wa jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.